Hey, hi, hello everybody and welcome to another episode of the Trinity War. I'm Faleg and today we are going to Soweto in South Africa. And for once I actually have a team that I could pick and choose rather than just take whoever is actually alive at the time. So let's go and heal some fucking aliens.
Dropship has arrived.
Alrighty then, so we are arriving at the mission site, and let us begin the assault.
We're heading to South Africa for this one, and we need to get down there fast. Alien activity continues to surge within several major cities. Our response is crucial to minimizing the spread of panic.
And I brought the team that is completely inadequate for the map, because I assumed I'm going to be fighting on an actual urban block, not inside one big giant bus building. So, I've been lied to. I feel like I have been deprived of critical mission-sensitive information.
This is Big Sky. Strike team has reached the AO. Requesting authorization to deploy.
Solid copy, Big Sky. Strike one is cleared to engage.
And we have Elliot right off the bat just waiting to say hello.
Headed there now.
Actually very good, because I can't wait to say hello to the aliens.
Boy.
So yeah, since we are fully capable of moving that far without activating any additional enemies or any enemies period. That was a bloody episode. I'm going to toggle flight and set up the sniper before we proceed, and I'm going to just try to set up the fight in a way that you know, complements Jungle Dragon's range right here.
It's the bloody rain! We are facing mutants today!
Well, that's fine. I think we can quite easily get to the conclusion that our enemy is inside the building.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Such being the case, we're gonna prep a little bit of a setup. Make sure that they are indeed over there, and then we're gonna blow them the fuck up. That's what's gonna happen. I'm considering just simply blowing the hole in the wall with the grenade, but I'm not going to do that. I'm totally not going to do that. Why would I ever do something so foolish and waste consumables on, you know, stuff that may not actually necessary even, you know, be a thing that works. Yes. What gave you that idea? But before I actually do blow the wall, I am going to use a motion tracker to see if those enemies are actually still there. Because, you know, we may be completely wrecking shop paper incorporated headquarters. But it's not gonna stop us from blowing everything up.
Take cover behind me.
I just got the feeling I can't stop myself. I'm gonna blow it up. Though I actually think that may not be possible. Well, how do we blow it up without actually blowing it up? I think that would be a good way. Hello! Oh, they were standing over there! That's way not where I wanted them to be. Anyway, kaplowy! Hello! Hello! If you don't kill, I'm gonna keep shooting you. Are you going to activate now, perhaps?
Aye, aye, Commander.
No? How about now? No. Well, alright then. Now we have this guy holo-targeted, and if he actually really does, he really, really refuses to just, you know, drop dead, then I'm gonna use that holo target to finish the unharmed guy. And then the harmed guy. And thus we eliminated the whole pod without actually activating it for the cost of one grenade. That was actually not only cost effective, but very much efficient, so... I feel a little upset right now. That was fairly not my point, to be efficient and effective at the same time. I just wanted to blow something up. But hey, in any case, we got another pod right over here, according to the motion tracker, along with the piece of meld that is probably like 5 or so, so I'm not gonna be bothering with that. However, I am going to set up everybody somewhere around here, so that we can simply activate the next pod next turn and blow them up. Incognito Kitten should probably reload, but he's not gonna, because that would actually make sense. So instead we are going to go and wipe the floor with aliens.
Affirmative. Moving out.
It's killing time.
And Jungle Dragon is gonna steady weapon, so that when enemy comes, they die. It would be so lovely if they would decide to patrol into me, but if they don't wanna, that's okay. Oh! Oh my! And one of the Overwatches actually hit. Is it my birthday or what? I'm gonna go with the Orwatch. Let's do that example. And be very surprised by the sudden and unnecessary activation of the second pod right on the other side of the wall, which doesn't make any sense, but puts our sniper in jeopardy, so I have to think now. Okay, so we have to get rid of the mutants, that should be easy. We're just going to lob a grenade with Vyacheslav and then send Jesavirs to kill them all within the zone. And that's going to leave everybody else free to deal with the impending doom. Then we could also command the Vyacheslav to blow up that wall and thus give us the visibility on the other fellas that we are going to need to fight. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move Vyacheslav right here.
Position confirmed.
That's gonna make my life relatively easy.
Cover position here.
I would be delighted to actually use a prox mine as well, but since I am facing two pods right now, then I will just have to blow up both the cars. And send Jesavirs wherever you are. There you are. You are going to have to deal with those guys. So you stand over here in the zone, those three fellas, and use your last shot on the last guy. So let's start from the back. That's why I gave you the biggest gun. Okay. So far so good, and your last bullet goes here. You actually survived, oh my god. Well, as much as I don't actually mind, he's going to die next turn. It is annoying as hell, because it basically costed me right now a turn. So what I'm going to do is simple. I'm going to run everybody as far to the left as they will need to go to be effective.
I'm on it, Commander.
Unfortunately, we can't really get the suppression at the right angle because the car that we would use to suppress is actually going to explode. I'm going to let that mutant simply shoot because screw this guy. I honestly can't think of anything else. Cat Incognito is going to wait, because he's gonna run and gun and tank the other fellas. Same goes for OP Metal Penguin, because we have to disable the mectoids. So, let's start the fight. Disable the mectoid number one. I could actually... It would be a better idea to shoot the other one instead. Because I don't know where will OP Metal Penguin be able to stand yet, so that was a tactical mistake. Which makes me feel much better, because, you know, making tactical mistakes is everything in my life. Oh, okay, now Vyacheslav is going to be completely unfazed by the fact that he will probably be blowing up way too much of everything. It's okay, though, we don't have to stand right next to that car. If it explodes, see, that's the important part, if it explodes. Now, we need to get the OP Metal Penguin to shoot the Mectoid in the back with a disabling shot, which he can do, thus making it possible for us to survive this time. Hello, you fool. I love you. You're going to die. I'm stupid. 10-4. There you go. Let's now run and gun Incognito Kitten for a nice little rapid fire on this little fella. Because we really don't want our sniper to die for no apparent reason, right? There is the sectoid, but I can't reach him. Okay, now we have a simple choice. What do we do? Well, I'm going to go and suppress that remaining mutant. He is under red fog and everything, so chances are he's just gonna hunker and then be killed by the exploding car, but he may be going away and trying to do stuff. And I decided after all that I don't feel like being shot. Now, you are a sectoid commander, so you are definitely going to go and... Oh no! What if that wouldn't be a tank, but instead somebody who's not a tank? I think they are running away. They're afraid! They're afraid! Well, who wouldn't be in that situation? Oh yes, yes, I know. Cars explode everywhere. We're gonna have to get away from that parking lot, because the cars on the other side of the parking lot tend to explode as one line, and it may still happen. Okay, so first things first, let's snipe away on the MCtoid that is not currently disabled. They are both disabled, okay. So let's shoot this guy. He's down. Because the Mectoids are basically just dead meat right now, so why would I bother? Heading there now. Providing cover at my location. Let's make sure they have something to think about. Deploying mine. Mine! It's all mine! It's not okay. That kind of mine, but it's still mine! Well, we shredded one. That was the point, and that happened, even if we did miss a very easy hit, but it's okay. Now, since we have one shredded, let's start pew-pewing it a little bit. And yes, the late game janitor tactics are quite effective, but you have to, you know, get through the very difficult middle period. Okay, we can't flashbang grenade the sectoid commander, but I can put it under acid, so that's exactly what I'm going to do. That should lower its aim and make him more likely to use his mind powers. Which I will then use against him, obviously. I think I may actually even be able to do something even funnier still. No Overwatch. Ah, screw it, he shot. No! Oh yes, my mind powers work as well. The big nope of absolute nobleness is going to allow me to burn this mother lover. Blow up the Protz mine too. I wasn't sure if the flamethrower actually does it, but it does. Lovely.
I'm rolling. Ready to rock.
All right. So now let's see what the enemies will do.
They're moving around the side.
Oh no, they are shooting the tank. Will you reload finally? No? Will you reload finally? Que pasa, mi amigo? What is going on? I think they reloaded, but I'm not sure. In any case, they're both dead. As disco. And that is actually pretty perfect, even though that was very surprising that we didn't manage to shoot this mechtoid to death. But oh, that's the not shredded one, okay, that's fine. Well, it's not like having a choice, I would, you know, bother. I think we may have a little bit of an issue with the sector commander. It seems as though he does not want to be shot. Don't worry about it. I don't think the car is going to explode, and even if he's not gonna do anything to incognito hit them. So, let's just chill. I should also be able to set up a little bit of a suppressive fire next turn. But next turn we are going to kill that sector regardless of what happens right now, so it's quite pointless really to do that. Ouch! Whoa! Whoa! Surprise! Oh, this is not the end of the mission after all. Oh well. So, maybe putting tank purposely in a position that the exploding car would burn him might not have been the best idea after all. But hell yeah, don't tell me it was. And yeah, I think it is now time to waste one of the medkits. We aren't being paid for bringing them back.
Position confirmed.
Well, at least not enough to actually bother.
Good as new.
We are good as new, and we are going home.
Moving out.
Because it's time to wipe the floor with the rest of the map. And also, let's make absolutely certain that not a single stone is left unturned in this building that we are trying to save, right? Because we must be absolutely certain, up to the very foundations and cellar of this building, that there is no single alien hiding anywhere. We have three more proximity mines, so let's use them wisely.
What was that?
Because we are not the hero this paper facility needs. We're the ones it deserves.
Boy.
I'm actually gonna reload just on the way.
Headed there now.
And yes, since I apparently just found out that I can use flamethrower combination of with prox mine, even though I was absolutely convinced that this is not a thing, I'm now a much happier person. You can possibly imagine the repercussions of that throughout the rest of the mission. Okay, let's land.
Landing.
Chances of actually getting to use the sniper with the jetpack again are very, very slim. Seemingly, the enemies are on the other side of that wall right here. So while I will be using the motion tracker to find exactly where they are, I will be doing it next turn.
Heading there now.
For now, let's just rush everybody to the, you know, relative safety of the inside of the building, where I am very much hoping they will try
to go
and surprise me
on my way
with their advance, to which I will be responding in kind, in a very, very deadly, very shooty, and hopefully effective kind. Come on, ambush me, ambush me, ambush me, ambush me!
What was that sound?
Yes, what was that sound? Hello. Oh well. It's time for the motion tracker. It seems the enemies are right over here. I mean, right behind that wall. So they have indeed surprised me.
Okay.
Well played.
Clear to engage.
Whoa! Well played indeed. Okay, fortunately sectopods aren't super fast, so what we can do is we will simply hide and have them come closer, and then we will poke outside of the wall and chuck them full of polka dots, shall we? It all hands down to Jessa right now. You can do it, baby. You have Titan armor in any case. Not that wall. Well, that made my life less than complete. We are now in half cover. If cover at all. Are we in cover? I would wager we aren't. Well, shit. Okay, in that case we are going to have to attack. So this is what we will do.
I'm on it, Commander.
Okay. Bear with me because this is gonna be stupid. How far does time mine fly? Quite far, okay.
Moving to position.
I just have to protect my scout's life right now, so everybody's gonna get a little bit wounded. But it's okay, because I don't give a shit. The important part is everyone will survive.
Deploying mine to that position.
Okay, now we can.
Firing incendiary.
No boom. Oh, there we go. We can apply some red fog to the sectopods. And that's going to recall the drone. So I can just hopefully yes. Okay, drone is going to go and fix the sectopods. Sectopods are going to go and try to find an angle.
Okay.
With which to, from which to shoot that. I'm going to try an angle from which to shoot the sectopods next turn. There we have it. Cat Incognito is going to run and gun and attempt to rapid fire shred one of them, which I should probably do before the flamethrower attack, but I panicked. Yeah, I should have done that before the flamethrower, then we would be dealing a little bit more damage, but it's okay. And Oki Metal Penguin is going to use the full cover to disable one of them. I would disable both, but the other sniper can see them.
Take a chill.
Wouldn't I at least at the beginning of the turn. And last but not least, we are going to put some. Now, I ponder. Put some acid on them, or put some smoke cover on us. What would be good? I think safety is always the better choice, so I'm going to do the opposite. What's the worst that could happen? There we go. Drone is progressing according to the plan. Repaired us for the shredding value. This is the only shooting enemy right now. And he hit for a lot of armor and actually even managed to damage, which is quite. Well, yeah. Unfortunately, this had to happen. I was trying to avoid it, however, it was absolutely inevitable because of reasons. Now we have to take down this Overwatch and kill the other guy. So the question is, how do we go about doing it? A, we can, and we probably should, use a disable shot to do that. However, and I mean however, when have I ever done something that I should have done? Well, once, by accident, but, you know, don't tell anybody. And yeah, if you think that this damage to the mech armors was significant, think about what would be the damage to our Jessavirs standing in the open barrage by the Sectopods.
Target's still up.
Okay, let's first of all shred the other guy, because this is super important right now.
Good to go.
Not this guy. Yes, this guy. Rapid fire. Pew pew. Okay, so this is the guy that is going to be killed. And the other one will also. Okay, Oppie, good luck. Kaplowy, mother lover. What Sectopods?
Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished. We have taken a lot of mech armor damage, which could be avoided. If one thing didn't happen, that thing was they shot destroying the piece of cover that our scout was trying to hide behind. So it forces us into moving even more aggressively than I usually would. But it's okay, we have only 6 days out for Netmare, which is completely fine. Because... we're gonna go with advanced fire control, because it's proxying with close combat specialist, I think. And I can't remember, so yeah, it's probably. Anyway, we got a lot of things. We broke a
remember, we will be watching.
But it's okay, because I've set IP to be fixed right now, and let's scan a little bit ahead, see what's gonna happen. Yay, we have a plasma cannon. And let's see. Where is one of the flyers that don't have it? There you go. Have yourself a merry little plasma cannon. Merry Christmas and a happy new year. And that means you can get the laser cannon. There you go.
Contact detected.
And we have an abductor going for in the for abductions where, so I'm gonna let it land because I have no other choice. And that means we have a nice little lovely set of abductions in Mother Russia for Commander Pounce on Monday. For now, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, let me know in the comments, like it, follow me on Facebook and Twitter and so on and so forth. And I will be seeing you again soon. For now, see you later and bye bye. I've been Faleg.